Last year, we officially released our WPF Gantt control. This year, we've refined its capabilities so you can do more and deliver Microsoft Project-inspired solutions to your end users. In this short tutorial, I'll discuss our most recent feature, the ability to assign resources to individual tasks displayed within the WPF Gantt control. This version 20.1 feature is set to ship in early May 2020. To help demonstrate the potential of this new feature, I'm going to use a sample we ship as part of our standard WPF distribution. To follow along, feel free to download our free trial from devexpress.com/try. Before I start, a word or two about resources. First, our WPF Gantt control allows you to assign one or more resource records to individual tasks. Resources can be anything you choose. They can be individuals, employees, physical equipment, etc. Anything you need to successfully complete an actual task. To bind resource records to a task, you're obviously going to need a collection of resources. Once you have your collection, you simply bind this to the appropriate property. You also need to have a link collection between your tasks and your resources. This is a task property that associates the resource to the task. As you can see in this demo, the tree list includes a resource column alongside the Gantt timeline. If you enable editing, your end users can modify resource records associated with each task directly within the tree list. Once I click a cell in this column, our Gantt control automatically displays a dropdown with a list of available resource records. In this particular example, the dropdown includes two grid columns. The first displays the actual resource name, and the second displays allocation percentage. I'll select a few resource records and press OK. Note the Gantt's timeline. These new resource records are displayed directly within the Gantt. Very cool. Now I'll move to another task and modify time allocation information. Once I change allocation percentage values and press OK, the Gantt timeline is automatically updated to reflect the change. Again, very cool. Before I wrap up this short tutorial, I'll change demos and show you how to customize the Gantt's timeline and to fine-tune the resource dropdown for maximum usability. First, I'll select code examples and drill down into the color tasks by resources demo. In this example, we show you how to color tasks based on colors assigned to resources. For instance, if your management resource is green, you can apply the color green to tasks who have been assigned the management resource. Similarly, if red is assigned to a developer and a developer is linked to a task, you can apply the color red to the task itself. Next, let me move to the group resources in the editor example. As you can see, you have total control over data organization within the resource dropdown window. In this case, we've grouped resources by record categories. Finally, let me move to the custom resources example. In this instance, the dropdown actually uses a tree list and data is organized in a hierarchical manner. The bottom line is simple. You have full control over the resource dropdown window so you can create the best possible, the most intuitive user experience possible. And that's it. I hope you liked this brief overview of our Gantt control and its support for resources. If you liked this video, please give us a thumbs up. If you have questions, please comment below. And please remember to subscribe to this channel for more great DevExpress training videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for choosing DevExpress.